That's life. Actually, you don't care about what I say. You care about what you want to hear from me. And different people in this room hear different things, although I'm saying the same things. So processes that are inflexible to change, this means that you go to a company and say, all right, you have this process and you cannot change it, and things like this. Now, how can we overcome the obstacles? One of the main reasons is to have open communications between the team and between the customer. Open communications and clear communications. Proactive organization environment. What's the meaning of proactive versus reactive? Reactive means I must plan in order to see what's going to happen in the future. Reactive means I wait until the problem occurs and then I try to solve the problem. Right. Do you know the definition of a successful project? Actually, the definition of a successful project is what we call the triple constraint. What's the meaning of the triple constraint? Having defined the quality of the project and the scope of the project, then we calculate the time and what? The cost. So the definition of a successful project is to deliver on quality, on budget, on specs, and on scope. That's the definition. Right, the first quote about project problems were spotted by a Greek guy saying that most project problems arise in situations we have multiple projects. Why? Because the people are not working on a single project. What is the problem if you have different projects? People are putting 1 hour in one project, 2 hours on the next one, and so on and so forth. Now, who knows this book? My Life is Failure. Who knows Jim Johnson? Write down the name of the guy and the name of the book. Before you die, you must read this book. Yes? It's serious. It's one of the best books written for IT project management. My Life is Failure. I will tell you what Jim Johnson is doing. Jim Johnson is working for a company, actually it's his company, which is called Studies Group. What is Studies Group doing? It's the only company on the planet that collects statistics of failed projects. Since 1994, today they have checked 70,000 projects. Look at the data. What do you see? The green one are the successful projects. 16% in 1994, 35% in 2006. What is the red one? Failed projects. What about the yellow one? The yellow one are the delayed projects. What's the meaning of this diagram? 50% of your projects are delayed, or you spend more money on them. Look at the sample, 70,000 projects. Now, let's go to some details. This diagram describes the overtime projects. After 1998, every project that is delayed, it needs 84 more time in order to complete. So, if the original plan was for 12 months, the final plan will be for what? For 20 months or 2 years. Let's go to over budget. Over budget was very high, 2 times up. Now it's almost 50%. And it's the same for the last 10 years. Which means, on every project you spend more money, on average, you spend how much more money? 50%. And the next one, which is very interesting, which says we do not deliver all the scope we promised to the customer. We cheat. We tell him we're going to deliver you 100 specs, and what do we deliver? 60%. And how much we charge the customer? 100%, yes. So all the statistics come from this book I have just described. Now, in 2006, you know KPMG probably. Anyone from KPMG in here? KPMG did a big survey worldwide to find the three main reasons why do projects fail. What do you think was number one? Or number two? Tell me something. The main reasons for project failures. Scope, yes? Scope, right, we cannot get the requirements early. Actually, KPMG found three main reasons. The first one was unclear scope. The second one was poor project management processes. And the third one is executive buy-in. What's the meaning of executive buy-in? That the executives in the company do not support the projects, so the projects fail. Actually, MSF can help only the first two. Is that clear? Nobody can help you on the third one. If the company doesn't like the project, it's going to fail 100%. All right, let's go to the foundation principles. What are the foundation principles? Are guiding concepts on how the project team should work. Actually, there are 9 foundation principles in MSF. First of all, open communications. What's the meaning of open communications? Do not hide information. Give all information to all team members. Second one, shared vision. What's the meaning of shared vision? Deliver the project. Empower team members. What's the meaning of empower team members? The project manager should not tell the project members what to do. What's the meaning of empowerment? Give the problem to the team members and let them solve it. Clear accountability and shared responsibility. Everybody should know what to do and what he is accountable for. Incremental value. What's the meaning of incremental value? You're going to see that we are going to divide the project into phases. Incremental value means at the end of phase one, we're going to deliver something to the customer. On the phase two, something more, and so on and so forth. Stay agile. Why stay agile? Because everything changes every day. Look at quality. Question for you. Do you test your applications? Who can tell me how many testers you should have for every developer you have? Actually, if you write operating system, for every developer, you must have 2 testers. If you write original applications, for every developer, you must have what? 1 tester. So if you have 5 developers, you must have 5 testers. Because testers are the people that increase the quality of the products. Learn from experience. Good and bad experiences. These are called lessons learned. And partner with customers. All right, let's go to mindsets. MSF has got 8 mindsets. The first one. We have a team of peers. What's the meaning of team of peers? It's not a hierarchy. Project manager is not the boss. We have a team of peers. Second one, focus on business value. Not on technology. Why we do not focus on technology? Because the customer doesn't care about the technology. The customer cares about what? He cares about the product. Actually, he cares about the money because he wants the product to make money. Right. Do your customers ask you about the technology you're going to use to deliver the product? Yes or no? Sometimes they do, yes. If they are experts, yes, they do. Keep the solution perspective. This means when you deliver a solution, always look at the solution and try to deliver it. Learn continuously. All the time, try to learn. Quality, again. Deliver on your commitments. Keep the milestones. Look at the triple constraint. What about the best practices? Is anyone here from Siemens? Siemens? Siemens has got a methodology which is called PM at Siemens. Have you ever heard of it? PM and